Once a stretch limo, now all that remains is a mangled mess of metal. This is a crash test simulation. But in July of 2015, four women were killed when their limo crashed in Long Island, New York. And last October, a birthday celebration in upstate New York turned tragic in this stretch limo accident. In all, 20 people killed, including four sisters and two brothers. It was the most deadly transportation accident in the U.S. in almost a decade. But what is it that makes limo accidents especially dangerous?
Now, to show you what happens when a stretch limo like this crashes with dummies inside, we are at CAPE. This is one of the leading crash test facilities for commercial vehicles. And this is Nick Awabdi. He is the head engineer here. Nick, what are we seeing today?
We're just really looking for how these passengers will fare in this test today.
And let me show you what he's talking about. There are passengers inside. Here we go. This is one passenger. She's not wearing her seatbelt. There are two more back here, a total of five passengers in the back of the limo.
Engineers installing sensors and rigging cameras all over the course. Even high-speed cameras to capture every frame. Now, one final check inside the limo. And in the control room, they're getting ready too.
10-4, we'll confirm brake check now.
Stand by for countdown.
The crash, seconds away.
3, 2, 1.
Now watch as this stretch limo speeding at 35 miles per hour heads right towards that wall. Take a look from a different angle. And this is the moment the front of the limo smashes in. Now in slow motion, smoke filling the air, debris flying everywhere.
Look at all that damage, and that is just from 35 miles an hour.
And 35 miles an hour is not uncommon. Obviously, cars are traveling at higher speeds, but they can sometimes have the chance to pre-brake before they make an impact.
And this is the outside of the limo. Can we take a look inside?
Yeah, let's look.
All right. Remember, there was a woman sitting right here, and whoa, where'd she go?
From the inside, it is chaos. This unbelted passenger becoming a projectile. In slow motion, that passenger flying through the air, head smashing into the roof of the limo.
Inside the limo here, it looks like this passenger is wedged underneath this seat.
Yeah, so she was seated in the back of the limousine, and clearly she moved all the way to the front and somehow wedged herself underneath that cushion.
How bad are some of the injuries in here, do you think?
It looks to be a very serious, if not fatal, injury.
But what about those two belted passengers? This belted passenger experienced major whiplash.
And what about this passenger?
So this passenger was belted with a three-point belt, but slid down underneath the belt. It's not an ideal place to find yourself.
We showed Senator Chuck Schumer the results of CAPE's crash test.
That's mayhem.
She's a projectile.
Yeah.
And she ends up underneath the seat.
Oh my God.
In a 3-year span, two deadly limousine accidents occurred in the senator's home state, putting a spotlight on the industry's lack of regulation.
What's the most concerning part about this?
It's sort of the Wild West. Anybody in a garage can stretch them, and for every inch you stretch them, the more dangerous the limo gets, with no regulations.
So once they're modified, they're no longer regulated?
They're no longer regulated. There are no rules about what kind of safety standard should be in those.
And when people get into limos like this, seatbelts are kind of an afterthought.
Well, exactly. There aren't regulations even about those.
Would you ever let a loved one get in a limo?
I'd be really careful about it. I'd be really worried.
NBC News reached out to the National Limousine Association, offering them the opportunity to comment on CAPE's crash test, but they didn't respond to our repeated requests.